sent 3 separate expeditions into the Dark Temple. Not one has returned. I can't say for sure what's going on, but people who go in there, they don't come back.
What makes you say that?
Sounds I heard coming out of that place would send a Rancor running, if it was smart enough to run. You can survive the Dark Temple. I beg you to do me, and more importantly, the Empire, a favor. The expeditions I sent in were looking for specific data. I can spare the manpower. They were slaves, mostly. But the data is essential.
What do you want me to do?
I'd like you to find the slaves from the expeditions and bring back any data you recover. The slaves from the expeditions were equipped with data pads to store the data they collected. Bring back those data pads. This information's vital to future construction on Droman Kaas. It's not glamorous, but will you help?
I wouldn't call it a challenge, but it seems straightforward.
Amazing. Fantastic. Your help is invaluable. I'll mark the location the expedition last signaled from on your map. It's the best I can do. The Empire needs that data.
At last, the Dark Council has answered my petitions and sent a fine young Sith to help secure the temple.
What's happening here?
Of course, I've been ignored again. How stupid of me. If you're here, however, you must have the authority to enter the Dark Temple. You could still save this planet.
You have my complete, undivided attention.
The Dark Temple is ancient, built during a previous incarnation of our Empire. 1,000 years ago, our own Emperor buried his enemies here. These enemies remain powerful, even in death, which is why the temple was sealed. But now, something terrible has happened.
Some idiot went and woke them up.
With the Emperor's attention elsewhere, a group of ambitious but ignorant Sith thought to gain power by raiding the temple. They didn't find the relics they sought. Instead, they awoke an ancient Sith Lord, Lord Kallig, and their expedition plunged into madness.
Are they still in there?
The ones who still live, yes. Because Lord Kallig died by ambush, I believe he awakened unaware of his own death, and his expectations became reality. For those around him, his power overwhelmed all inside the temple. And even now the workers plot wars against each other, believing themselves Sith Lords, and drawing terrible power from Kallig himself.
Are there more dead Sith Lords in there?
Ah, you begin to see the crisis. There are still more ancient Sith Lords whose spirits lay dormant in the temple. If the ancient Sith Lords are woken by the violence within, they could overrun Droman Kaas.
Let's keep them napping.
I have studied all of the burial chambers within. Each was made with the same ancient design, one we can exploit. If you fuse the 500 kilogram hinges on each tomb door, even a violent assault should not be able to wake the ancients.
What exactly does this entail?
The team I sent in earlier was using a massive metal torch. Effective, but slow, I'm afraid. They did not make it far. The torch must be recovered, and the doors of the ancients sealed.
Thank you. headquarters, John. Usteans Alfras Nojob Diabulus Afstop Fara.
Thank you.
Sa Tidama.
chronometer tells me it has been exactly 963 years since this hologram was made. Have the Sith truly lived in fear of me for so long?
I guess that would depend on who you are and who you ask.
A careful answer. But you certainly don't need to fear me. This image is all that remains of Kelethur. Like so many before me, I challenged the Emperor and was buried in this temple. Fortunately, I had just enough time to make this, an interactive image that would transmit my secrets to whomever was bold enough to find my tomb and unlock it.
I unlocked your tomb, so start transmitting.
Patience, and everything will become clear. The way of the Sith lies in channeling the Force through the use of powerful emotions. Fear is the chief of these. The Sith feed on palpable dread.
What's the secret, then?
It's a lie. Fear is a lie. Passion, a lie. Fear gives temporary power, and passion is easily manipulated. Real strength in the Force comes when one is no longer afraid. And one can purge fear when one stops grasping, after power, after things, after life itself, and allows the Force to guide him. There is only the Force.
You're weak and a fool.
My peers obviously did not think so. They considered my teachings dangerous. What I learned only lives on through this image and its device. Yet I am one with the Force, eternal and at peace. Take them. Take my teachings to the Sith. They will find power there, but a different kind. Not of darkness, but light.
These heresies must be destroyed.
Then do so. Strike out against knowledge and see what comes of it. If you destroy these teachings, the light does not go out. Remember, fear is not the only way.
seem as if you were expecting me.
Ah, you don't know me. Has our family fallen so far that the son of my sons does not know the name of Kallig, the name so long revered in the annals of the Sith? You are my descendant. By how many generations, I do not know. But know this. Your strength in the Force has awakened me from my stupor.
I thought I was crazy.
Do not mock me, child. You do not even begin to understand who you are dealing with. When the weaklings of this planet trespassed my tomb, I rose, resuming my former life. This temple became my kingdom, and I was once more a lord of the Sith. But when you first grasped the hilt of your lightsaber, I knew my hour had come and gone. That your strength, not mine, would return our family to glory.
But I'm a former slave.
That is my shame. I was once one of the greatest lords of the Sith. If I'd been wiser, I could have secured my family's greatness. But I let down my guard and was betrayed by a man called Tulak Horde, whom I trusted as a friend.
Iblaces Amin's Waihais fools. Gawen Dida seek from Tauhans.
Ha! Your master is dead, beast. You serve the child of Kallig now. Flesh of my flesh, you should teach your servant to obey.
I defeated him once. I can control him.
Such confidence. Such pride. In restoring our bloodline to glory, you must not make the same mistake. Treachery is the Sith's endless game. You must win it.
I couldn't care less about our bloodline.
Fool! You think that you have risen to power in spite of your nothingness. But your nothingness must have had a purpose. And when that purpose is exhausted, you will go back to being nothing. Beware your master. Beware your apprentice. Never be taken by surprise. Do these things, and you will be unstoppable. But you have not come to see me. You have come for the artifact I managed to wrest from Tulak Horde before he died. Take the artifact, but be careful. I know not what it does. Only that betrayal follows it everywhere.
It wouldn't be worth taking otherwise.
Just keep your eyes open. I hunger for the day when our power will be restored. We will meet again.
Apprentice, do you have the artifact yet?
You wouldn't want to spoil the surprise now, would you?
Oh, you're teasing me, apprentice. Hurry back to Scotia's. I mean, my chambers. I have a surprise for you.
I love surprises.
Trust me, you'll love it. Now hurry back with the artifact. I can't wait.
hope you sealed the chambers of the ancients, Keleth Ur's chamber especially. I'm terrified to think what would happen if Keleth Ur and his crazed ideas were to reemerge.
Keleth Ur was nobody, some Sith who turned light side.
Do not underestimate the power of the light which eternally seeks to destroy us. Keleth Ur's secrets have been contained along with the other ancients. You have done well.